The attack on conservatives, the left attempts to silence conservatives, and whether that be with boycotts, if they don't like what you're saying, I know that they're constantly attacking conservative hosts on television, and they call for the grab your wallet people to come out and list your advertisers and all of these other things. But people on the right don't do that. You never see them going after some of the hosts that they disagree with. And also, too, if you think about what some of the mainstream media, they've been pushing conspiracies that the Russia hoax for quite some time. No one punishes them. No one even questions it.
You hit the nail on the head, Stephanie.
How do they get away with that? It's they can ask questions, but we can't ask questions.
The lack of consequence. There are no consequences. There's no consequences to lying, whether you're in the media and you print something that's not true. You just keep going. You just start the rumor and the next guy picks it up. No consequences. And the same as it relates to the left and what they do, whether it's a county executive, a governor saying stand down to their police when real people are being victimized, when Antifa is attacking them, or whether it's a conservative just trying to live their life. Why don't we do it? Because we believe in law and order. But I'll tell you when the conservatives are going to act. It's a conservative or Republican or someone who's a forgotten man and woman. They're going to act 2020 for the presidential election, I have no doubt. But my concern, Stephanie, for this election are illegals voting. They're getting licenses. They'll have identification, which may allow them in some states to vote. The Supreme Court has said in some situations that it's illegal and it's an undue burden for them to have an identification too. I mean, we've got real problems in this country, and I worry about the people getting the vote.
Well, some states are even trying to just keep President Trump off the ballot altogether, which seems very unconstitutional in every single way, shape, and form.
That is stunning. That is stunning. They are haters, and yet they don't find themselves to be that way. They think they're justified, and that is a frightening time. That is fascism. They say they're anti-fascist. They are fascists. I'm sorry. They are. In the book, Radicals, Resistance, and Revenge, I mean, I talk about their resistance and their revenge. They are radicals. They will do anything they need to stop us. That's not who we are. They will resist in any way possible. And that means if we are victims, they don't care. They will prevent law enforcement from doing their job. And if they need to shut us down, they will do that. And what we have to do, and that's why I wrote the book, we need to fight back. We need to make sure that we're heard. We need to get into education, get into schools, get into Congress, do all the things that need to be done to level the playing field, which is not level at all.
And I'm sure you've thought about this a lot, but how do we fix things? How do we get back to how we used to be?
We'll never be back to where we used to be. We've got a younger generation, millennials. We've opened up the borders, starting with Obama, to people who are not necessarily in favor of America, the American flag. I mean, when you've got sporting events, football players take a knee because they don't respect our flag. My father fought in World War II. My grandfather fought in World War II. How dare you? Unless you fought for the flag, don't you dare disrespect it. This is something that we have to get into the schools. We have to play their games. We have to be as ever sharp as we can be in terms of not just education, but in terms of getting the word out and in terms of getting people elected to Congress. Remember a few years ago, we talked about getting people from the military in Congress, and there was a real move to get those people into Congress. Well, now it's got to be people who believe in law and order and truth and justice. I never thought I'd say this. I spent 30 years as a prosecutor, a judge, an elected DA. I ran for office 5 times. I get this. I never thought I would see the country the way it is now, where you've got this Democrat clown car, a bunch of bozos. I mean, you got Joe Biden. Where is this guy? Does he have all his faculties? You know, his doctor says his brain is functioning. It may be, but I don't think the circuits are connecting.
How do we reach out to younger generations? You're talking about how you tend to lean to the left. A lot of it starts at schools, indoctrination, what they're seeing on TV, what they're seeing in magazines. How do we, I mean, I'm conservative and I worry about the younger generations as well. And that's something that's part of my focus is to reach out to young people and share the message. I used to work as a Democrat and I was an independent my entire life. And then after the Trump election, I was like, I would never vote for a Democrat ever again. So how do we get that message out? Is that something
you... Well, you know, I think that we've got to learn their lingo. And that means social media. That means, you know, television. You know, we underestimate the power of television. You know, the Obamas on Netflix, you know, taking these, you know, all of these, you know, the word I'm looking for are scenarios and narratives that end up in a very kind of liberal leftist socialist agenda. We've got to talk about socialism. We've got to reward young people like Charlie Kirk, Turning Point. He is doing a phenomenal job. I go with him to these speeches on college campuses, as you do too. High school, young women, talking to them, empowering them to be proud of who they are, be proud of this nation.